I'm going to briefly describe how to use this interactive simulation that looks at polymerization in a batch reactor. And we'll look at two types of polymerization. One is free radical polymerization. We have initiation, propagation, termination. And in this case, we have the options of changing the initial concentrations of both the monomer and the initiator. And then we can also change the three rate constants: the initiation rate, the reaction rate, propagation rate, and the termination rate. You also have concentration of the terminator can be changed. And then we can look at the polymer fraction versus the number of monomer units in that polymer as we change the time with this slider. The two fractions are the number fraction, the blue curve, corresponds to how many polymer units with that particular number of monomer units divided by the total number of polymer units. In contrast, the weight fraction, the green line corresponds to the weight of polymers with, for example, 10 monomer units divided by the total weight of polymers. So the number average is reported here, and the weight average here, and then the polydispersity is the ratio of these two values. We also have step growth polymerization, which is different behavior, and we'll look at that when we look at the interactive simulation. What we've done here is try to help you realize when this polymer fraction scale changes. So as we change time, we have to change the scale on the y-axis and also on the x-axis in order for you to be able to see the behavior. And this hopefully makes you aware. It's showing what the maximum value is for the y, and in this case, for the x. So let's look at the interactive simulation. So here's the interactive simulation. And first notice the red point or the red bar on the y-axis indicating the maximum is 0.25. What we can do is change the monomer concentration, and we're going to change the molecular weight distributions. We can change the initiator concentration. And we can change the various rate constants. So if we decrease the termination, then we expect the polymers to get bigger. And if we go to longer time, we can see how in a batch reactor, we progress. Of course, the monomer concentration, initiator concentrations are decreasing with time. We're calculating the weight average, number average, polydispersity. If we look at step growth, it's different behavior. Now you only can change the monomer concentration and the rate constant. And as we go to longer times, well, this keeps growing. Let's increase monomer concentration, reaction rates. Notice we're out to much larger monomer units on the x-axis and much higher molecular weights, and again, here's the polydispersity. So the idea by changing these parameters and this polymerization for the two types of polymerization, hopefully we can get a little better physical feel for the behavior if we carry out polymerization in a batch reactor.